So we are now 35 meters away. Oh no, but the sonar shows that we're 5 meters. There it is. We're at it. Wow.
Okay. There you go. Wow.
Yeah. Those are lots of sponges.
Okay, vessel in sight.
Welcome, everyone, to the shipwreck of the USS Independence.
First eyes on Independence in 65 years.
Oh, my God. Hello, mighty eye.
Sharing this with thousands of people all around the world right now.
Jim's been wanting to be here since 1992. Let's just give him a minute.
Wow.
Jim, you think we're looking at the 40-millimeter gun platform?
Could be. Could be. It has that shape right there aft, yeah. Stern,
Bob. We think it's the stern.
Wow. Yeah.
Another 5 meters.
The cruiser bow of CL-59, USS Amsterdam. Modified, added to become CVL-22, lead class of the light aircraft carrier, USS Independence. Look at that.
Incredible.
At Bikini, they wouldn't have kept the anchors. Oftentimes, the chains were simply shackled to large concrete mooring blocks to hold the ships in position. And many on all of those blocks remain in place from Abel and Baker on the bottom of Bikini Lagoon. Kelly Elliott, are you having the same sort of like unbelievable chills moment that I am? Did you ever think we'd be on this? Schwemmer, you must be going nuts too. This is unbelievable. Welcome to Operation Crossroads and its ships. You can see why I've talked so much about those dives at Bikini. It was just life-changing. See that hat? That's probably, is that an ammunition patch? John Lambert, that port that I see there on the deck, is that an ammo pass? Is that for a lift? For an elevator bringing up ammunition? Or is that just a man's a scuttle for a guy to go through? Looks awful small, but...
Have you seen this gun yet already?
We have, but we always like looking at Bofors 40 mils. I have a couple of now inert shells for one of these on my desk at home. It's a very big piece of metal. You don't want to have one of these shot at you. You can see here where these guys would come out to their action station, just coming out under from out of the deck there through the... out onto the walkway here, the gangway, coming around. That almost looks like there's still some paint on it. You see that?
Oh, yeah.
Allison's just going to come down a bit.
Jim, where's the...
We're liking this new view.
See the black there? See how there's not much growing on it? That's on the bulkhead, the side of the deck here?
Oh, on the ship. I was looking on the gun.
Yeah, now on the gun, it's...
Oh, yeah.
It's painted for sure, and that could be a... Well, what is it? I think that's just paint that's left. There's a fair bit of paint that's surviving here.
So the deck would have been painted under the wood?
Well, that's a section. That's below deck. You can see the mounts there for the cables?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Cable runs.
Yeah. I'm sort of so overwhelmed, I'm losing my language here.
Yeah. Don't really get worse.
Well,
I mean, as the night goes on.
Yeah, no, it's just incredible. Earlier in my career, to have dived on the ships from Crossroads, to know about Independence and to feel that she would forever be out of reach and out of sight, even though just 4 years before we started our dives, Bob had discovered Titanic. And now to be here and to see this, a reminder of something that very much influenced me as a much younger archaeologist to study the Cold War and the bomb. Led me to write the report with my colleagues on the ships and then to write the book Ghost Fleet, the sunken fleet at Bikini and Kwajalein. And now to see Independence. I'm awash in a sea of memories. And I also think of all those I interviewed and talked to back in the day who had lived through this. Men, different members of the crew of all of these ships. I interviewed the pilot who dropped the bomb.
Is that a gun?
Yep.
Anti-aircraft gun?
That's it looks...
Is that a 20 millimeter?
Yes, that is a single 20 millimeter anti-aircraft gun, an Ehrlichan.
But that's pointing backwards.
Well, it could have just been blown back
no,
there.
No, I'm not. I'm not saying they were firing it backwards.
Yeah, but now that's a 20. That's a 20 millimeter anti-aircraft gun, an Ehrlichan. I'd like to get a nice shot of that, guys. Look at the starfish there. Just so many of these guys who are no longer with us. They're talking to them and interviewing them and hearing their stories. And then to be here now, wow. And to know that some of this great generation still lives on with us. Oh, there she is.
There's the cockpit.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there she is.
Yeah, there she is.
Yes.
Wow.
I want to give a shout out to my brother-in-arms and fellow archaeologist Frank Kentelis from NOAA's Office of Ocean Exploration and Research. When looking at this data, along with Bob Schwimmer and I, Frank said, you know, that looks like there may be an aircraft down there. Frank, thank you. Thank you. That was one of the inspirations for this.
So does it look like the wing broke off?
It does.
Yeah.
She may have been shifted and thrown the sinking. We knew that aircraft had been in place. We knew that in the case of Saratoga, one of those of us have dived her as well as others now, that aircraft are still there because they sank with Saratoga. What we weren't sure of was the survival of aircraft on Independence. In going after Frank made his observation on the sonar, went back and in the archives, the Bureau of Aeronautics Group from Operation Crossroads wrote a detailed report. Everything, of course, was inventoried, and they noted that two aircraft had been placed on board, and the ones at Bikini, you can read them.
Okay.
The only things that a lot of these aircraft were missing when they went out to Crossroads were their clocks, according to the records.
Hey, Amber.
View Air kept very careful records on this.
Go full 100% zoom on that. That's it? That's everything?
Oh, yeah? That looks like a throttle?
Yeah, it looks like a nut. You can see a number on it.
What are we seeing inside the cockpit?
So, just really quickly while we're going, is... ladder upside, John Lemmer says. Hellcat gun position.
I see.
Whoa, look there. Ruben, do you see in that instrument?
The writing?
See the writing down below, the larger SL or SC? You see what's down below that? Are you at max zoom?
We are, yeah.
Okay. Are you getting screen captures? Perfect. Okay. So the island actually does not sit on the flight deck. It's cantilevered out over the starboard side. Oh. So this crane would have had a large boom arm, and that is gone. That was noted as being missing after the Able test detonation. Here, as we get closer to the flight deck, as we move past the base of the crane, what you can see coming up out of the steel of the deck are the fasteners that once held down the Douglas fir planking on this flight deck. That's what you see down there looking spots on the steel.
Jim, if we find paint, are we just looking for the degradation?
No, we're looking to see what the paint actually says to us. But it's also important to look if the paint gives us a sense of ongoing changes. Look at that. That you see the lines there?
Yeah.
Any designs or outlines in the paint? looks like surviving paint in a way, but another deep water wreck. I mean, like with the subs at Pearl, remember we yeah. there was paint.
Yeah.
So in this area, as you're passing, as we continue to pan to the right, the hull would have been painted with the ship's number and name. There may be no trace of that anymore, but on some deep sea wrecks, we occasionally do see surviving paint. What you're looking at is the base of a 40 millimeter gun tub, 40 millimeter anti-aircraft weapon would have been placed here. We have a surviving veteran who served on USS Independence who lives in the San Francisco Bay Area, Philip Weyer. This was his gun station, and he was interviewed by some of our colleagues and shared his memories. Here you see the ladder in which these guys would have climbed up into the gun tub. At the base of it there below the tower, you see the mount, the pintle for the 40 millimeter, and now the welded steel of the Christmas tree or the blast gauge tower. These Christmas trees were emplaced on all of the target vessels, usually in elevated positions or at bow and stern. I've seen them on wrecks out at Bikini. And at the top of this tower, when just coming into view, would be the actual gauge itself. And those holes that you see bored in there capture that. That is the means by which they measure the burst. That would be lined behind with foil. Depending on the various pressures, that foil is going to rupture in different places. So it's simple but effective means of gauging the types of pressures generated in the air shock waves of an atomic bomb. This one has been partly disassembled to take the readings and, you know, to get the burst plates out, leaving only the basic structure of it. An ingenious reminder of the dawn of the atomic age as scientists grappled to understand and to measure forces that many thought were unmeasurable and incomprehensible until the beginning of nuclear weapons and, as I said, the atomic age. Powerful and evocative artifact of the start of the Cold War. We're still above the waterline, and you have closer to the waterline, you do have access doors and companionways that go in. You see off to the side, that may be a porthole.
Maybe.
Is that door open?
It is.
I don't think the door is there anymore. It's all eaten away or something.
The door, the frame of the door is there. The paneling of the door is gone.
Wow.
Right.
Oh, nice.
That's an example of what John was talking about.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah, that's a
And we're looking inside at a lower level. We're looking inside the hull of USS Independence.
What's in there?
This is such a cool view.
Can you zoom in when you get a chance?
Sure.
See that scuttle that's fallen there?
Yep, let's go ahead, Bob, and zoom in.
Focus inside.
Piping.
Mm-hmm.
Overhead. Looks like some of the asbestos lagging from the piping. Maybe. Snow. Yeah, that's asbestos from the steam pipes there. See how it looks like straw?
Like yeah.
Yeah, all the steam piping down there is asbestos. It's inert in the water and not going anywhere, which is a good thing.
I'm like right at the very end of my tether here.
I hear you. And there
and
it is.
And here are the letters as well.
Every night in my dreams, I see you, I feel you. That is how I know you. Go on.
Yeah,
we're
look
going
at that.
To put
I
out
think that's
a
enough
gym.
For fair use.
Exactly.
Later.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's I don't want a lawsuit here, but no. Wow.
All right, we're gonna.
Can we zoom in on
the vehicle
yep.
over
Bladders?
There? Get a
sure.
nice
yeah.
zoom.
So, and those is that just painted or are those elevated?
We're about
they
to find
almost
out.
Look raised to me.
Look elevated.
Oh yeah, they
to me,
look.
There's ridges there
they
for
look
sure.
Definitely
it's just
raised.
Like on the Arizona.
Wow. So clearly an E.
C-N-C-E.
N-C-E in field right now, but right across there. We imagine they probably spilled their whole
There's
thing.
The E.
There we go. That's awesome. That is called dropping the mic and leaving for the watch change.
The P
have
is obscure.
To four.
Yeah.
Those dang
Just
sponges
amazing.
Have no respect for this name we're trying to find right now.
No, it's all part there, of that whole
ashes.
There's
a D underneath those two goiter sponges.
Yep.
There's a D.
Yep. Under the goiter sponges.
Yep, there we go. There's the D. Wow. Jan, did you think we'd see this? That's bomb damage. That's bomb damage. Wow. Independence.
We have been exploring now for about 8 hours on Independence. Visual surveys of both sides. We've been able to see an airplane inside the airplane hangars. We've seen, oh, geez, just so much. The Christmas trees that we hoped to see that held the pressure gauges, peak pressure gauges during the detonation. We've thankfully found all of the
Let me try this coming back towards Argus because they'll be able to do a little more stable.
Flags down. Which will enable our mapping operations to continue in the next portion of the dive. Now the name on the stern. Incredible set of discoveries here, along with just being able to witness this piece of American history.